Aspen, I mean, I guess it might be tough to put into words, but the emotional roller coaster that I imagine this has been the last couple of weeks, what's it been like for you?
Oh, it's been pretty unreal. Obviously, the last time was pretty terrible. And then coming home from that, I was home for a few days. I was basically disconnected from people, social media, everything. And then I get this call. It's like, well, that was unexpected, but sweet.
I know you took ownership right away. You said, look, I know what's going to happen, but this is just the reality of what it is. People still were not very kind to you. I guess you said you unplugged. Were you surprised at all to get that kind of reaction? Or did you just know, like, I know this is exactly what's coming?
No, I knew that was exactly what's coming. Especially with what we do, we're very accessible in the media. And social media wise, people are always on there. So it's not surprising. When you do well, you do well. When something bad happens, you get shit on.
What was going through your mind that morning of weigh-ins? I mean, did you know, like, there's just no way this is going to happen? And, I mean, do you have to have those battles? Like, do we keep trying? And, I mean, do we put our health at risk? I mean, what was all that like?
No, we were still trying up until the end. Like, 3 hours trying to get the last pound off wasn't going to happen. Didn't happen. Went right to weigh-ins from cutting weight and did the best we could.
And I guess I didn't, to be certain, did the commission rule you ineligible or did she decline to take the fight?
No, she declined to take the fight. But that's her right.
I was going to say, did that frustrate you at all? I mean, do you feel like that added to what happened? I mean, do you put any of that blame on her?
No, I don't blame the other fighter. I mean, it's in the reverse of the situation. I would have taken it, but that's just because also she's getting a fair chunk of my purse. But everybody reacts things differently and makes their own decisions, and she chose not to fight. And that's, as I said, her right.
So the fans, obviously, they're going to say what they say. You had Miesha Tate come out and criticize you pretty hard. I mean, I guess there's some history, and maybe it's all about some matchmaking, especially since she's active. But did that, you know, register on your radar, and what did you make of all that?
A little bit. I respect Miesha very much as a fighter, and I've wanted to fight her since she came back. She is probably one of the biggest names in women's MMA besides Ronda and Cyborg. So when she came back, I think all the 35ers wanted a piece of her. And I'm one of them. So I don't know. There's just a thing where somebody else is going through something that's not very pleasant. I'd rather never make them feel worse or comment on it. It's like, why? You're just putting more negativity out there. Other people don't feel that way. So we'll see. Maybe we'll meet down the road.
In her accusation especially, because it's one thing for people to talk about you missing weight, right? It's another one to maybe call in your character that you're attempting to cheat the system. I mean, did that stand out to you, or what do you say to people that you were trying to cheat somehow?
No, I was dying at the time. Very, very bad all the way around. But, I don't know, everybody's different, man. Everybody thinks their own way and acts their own way, whether it's negative, positive, whatever.
Fair enough. So all that gets over. You get back with the team. At that point, is the decision made like, hey, we're going to 45, or does the UFC call and say, hey, we've got this opportunity at 45, what do you think? How did that play out?
We'd been planning on going to 45 as well as 35, but 45 the last couple of years we've been talking about it, and the UFC was aware of that. Before this last fight, there was talk of doing a 45 fight instead. It was just trying to get through that last one. And is 45 the only weight class? No. It's just going to take me a good long while to do 35 and do it healthy. But no, we've been talking about 45 for a while, and this fight was completely unexpected. Like, they called me on Wednesday.
So it wasn't like you volunteering. It was them reaching out to you and saying, yeah. Oh, by the way, here's something we got for you.
Yeah, no, heck no. What happened was as soon as Holly fell out, and I don't know who they called first. I'm assuming they probably called other people, but Norma's a dangerous opponent. I didn't know anything about her. I didn't know it was 5 rounds. I did not know it was main event. I just knew that Holly fell out and the fight was 45. And I was like, all right, sweet. This feels kind of like fate. Let's do it.
So what happens when they say, oh, by the way, it's 5 rounds, and oh, by the way, it's a main event? Is that like intimidate you, or is it crazy? Do you like it? How does that feel?
It's like, well, shit, let's do this. That's honestly, it was exciting.
What have you learned about Norma in the time since? I mean, I'm sure you've probably studied some tape or what. I mean, what do you know now about her?
Heavy striker. She comes to bang. She throws hard. She throws down. And I think this is a potential fight of the night.
But to be clear, you're saying this is not your permanent division. It's going to be your division for a while. You expect to do this for a while, but you do see a return to 35?
I do. We'll talk after this fight with the people that matter about if the next one will be at 35 or 45. But obviously, I can take a 45 on a 10-day notice. I can take a 45 on a 6-week notice kind of thing. 35, I cannot. It takes me a long time and has to be exact. So this is just an opportunity for me to fight more and to be more healthy doing it.
And healthy, I think, is the key word, right? So I think people were curious, like, how much would you go up? Like, is this 2 weeks? Has it been two more weeks of weight cutting to keep you at 45? Or, I mean, do you feel healthy? What has this time been like?
I'm not cutting weight to make this fight. I've been trying to get to 35 for so long that you get pretty low. And I had not put on much weight by the time they called me for this one. So a couple days of dieting, and no, there's no weight cut involved.
I'm sure you probably haven't paid attention to it, but there are fans that say she doesn't deserve this opportunity. You know, you just missed weight. How can you be in a main event? Have you heard any of that? And if so, I mean, how do you address that?
Oh, yeah. Well, we're the ones that are ready to take it. You got to use your brain a little bit there, a little bit of deductive reasoning. After the last one, do you think they called me first? No. They called other people, and it's a dangerous opponent on short notice. Nobody else took it. We did. So we get the opportunity.
Nice. Last thing for me. 45 is an interesting division, right? Because there's not a lot of fighters there. So, I mean, you win here. I mean, we're talking about title discussion, aren't we? I mean, do you feel like, hey, I could go from this into a fight with Amanda Nunes?
The same woman is at the top of both heaps there, and it's the same very dangerous opponent. I don't know. 45 is very interesting because right now there's not much substance. But I think they're about to sign Kayla Harrison. At least they're going to try to. She had her last fight with PFL, and I think they're going to build the division around her. They want new blood and new faces. So I think over the next couple years, featherweight, if that happens, will flesh out pretty good.
Hey, Aspen, just going back to the last weight cut and stuff. When she's saying, no, I don't want to take the fight now that you're overweight, do you have any negotiations? Can you offer her more of your purse? Or is there many talks in trying to get her to take that fight? Because I assume once you're on a scale, you're like, look, it's what it is. I still want to fight tomorrow.
Yeah, no, we wanted to fight regardless. And she was already taking a very decent chunk, and obviously there was discussions like, is there anything we can do? But no.
Did she give, or do you know any reason why she decided to say no? I know it's her right, but did she give any inclination as to why?
Just she decided extra is her right not to take it.
You said that you expected the fans and you expected the backlash you're going to get. Does that make it easier or harder? Does that make it when you go, well, I know I'm about to get shit on, so whatever, or it's like, oh, I'm about to get shit on, this is going to really suck?
I think it depends. Like, it only really matters if it's somebody you care about. So, yeah, it's not pleasant when you have 500 douchebags you don't know talking shit, more than that. But at the same time, it's not like it's my family. It's different.
Does it, I mean, we spoke about it a minute ago, does it hurt worse than when it's one of your peers like Miesha?
Not at all, because I want to fight Miesha.
Thank you very much.
All right.